Today I'm going to share steps for how to take that fantastic clicky fidget and adjust it so we can print it face down in Bambu Studio. So let's get cracking. Friends, you can get to Tinkercad by visiting www.tinkercad.com. I always choose sign in with Google. Now in Tinkercad, everything is saved to the cloud. I remember that this one was named Fidget, so I'm going to click over here on search. Not this search. This is searching the world. This is searching my designs. And if I type Fidget, this is the clicky fidget that we're talking about. It says restored because I had to back up using version history. Today, I'm going to click on duplicate so that I don't wreck what I did back then. So this is the fun clicky fidget project. It has got this piece that we traced using the sketch tool, and then we added all of these details and filled it in so that we could print it in multicolor. Now, I like to print these with them raised up. I like the texture and it prints faster because all of the yellow can happen and then the colors, but a lot of users want to print these face down for the texture. Let me show you the steps to make that happen. So, of course, you're seeing this project after I completed it. If you want to complete this tutorial, this bit.ly or the card up here in the corner will get you to it. To make it so it prints flush, we're just going to do the following. First, I'm going to move this all to the side. I'm going to grab these pieces and do Control D and move them over here. And then I'm going to make a copy of the pink piece, Control D, and I'm going to make it a hole. If we check its thickness, it is 0.8. I'm going to change that instead to 0.5. That's just the default number I like to use. Then I'm going to shift select the yellow piece, choose L for align, make the yellow piece the boss, and I'm going to make sure this lines up right with that top edge. So what we're going to do is we're going to cut out where the pink piece will sit. I also need to click on the green piece and do Control D. We'll make it a hole. Of course, we'll double check this thickness, make it 0.5 as well. All these numbers will be the same. Shift select on the yellow, L for align. We want the yellow to be the boss and make it line up with the top as well. Real quickly, I'm going to hide the pink piece. I'm going to hide the green piece. And if we grab all of those and do Control G, they will all group. Notice there are these little edges out here. Let me show you how we're going to get rid of those artifacts. So I'm going to ungroup this. And I'm going to click on this part, and I'm going to ungroup it. And what this will let us do is eventually we've got one of these that is just a sketch. If we click on this sketch, we can check its stroke. And the current width is 1.4, and it's set to go to the inside. If I set this to center, and I double it, so instead of 1.4, I'm going to go 2.8. It's going to cut all the way around the outside of our shape and stay with the inside of our shape. That, my friends, is why we went through all the work back in the real tutorial of tracing our sketch. It gives us these possibilities. So with our new parts put together, let's grab them all and do Control G to group. Check it out. None of the little edges. If we do show all, bang, we've got all of our little parts. With my old system, this worked. When these were 0.4, the pink actually shows through. If we're going to try and make this flush, we need to build this better. We're going to just trace this a little bit more precise. We're going to start by putting the work plane on the yellow, and then simply bring out your sketch anywhere close to that area. When it shows up, we are just going to click and trace these pieces. I'm going to tell you to put the snap grid to off, that way you can be more precise. And you want to be as close as you can. We click and press number 2 to start. And when you click up here about halfway, you just bend this out so it gets close. And then you follow that all the way down. Since we're using number 2, the Bezier curves, you can click and twist. I'm going to try and go around this corner, click and twist. Bring it up as far as I can. And you're just getting as close as you can. Click and twist. But you also want as few curves because that makes it easier. More curves actually makes it more difficult. These I can do straight, so I'm just clicking the straight line, click and bend, hold and twist. I'm going to put back number 1 so this one is straight. I'm going to hit number two to do a Bezier curve, bend it around, click hold and bend. You can edit these afterwards, so that way it doesn't have to be perfect. And the more you play with these, the better you get. Click hold and twist. Hit number one to go back to the other kind. Hit number two to do a Bezier curve. I like to go about middle and middle. Straight ones are my favorite. And then click hold and twist. Once you're done, you can double click. This right here is a smooth curve. Notice it bends in both directions. If you hit number three, it becomes a broken curve, so that way they each move independently and you can line it up much faster. Simply work around switching them to broken handles when you need, and of course twist and adjust until it looks the way you want. If these dimensions are ever in your way, you can click right up here to shut them off in an instant. You can tweak and adjust a ton, but do remember your slicer is pretty smart as well. You don't have to be perfect. Once I hit finish sketch, remember, of course, that needs to be set to 0.5. I'm going to make it the green just because that's the way I wanted it to show up. We don't have to be perfect up here, but I do want to make sure there aren't any gaps. If you want to make adjustments, you can double click. I'm going to let the slicer fix the parts where it overlaps. Just use those same adjustment skills until you're absolutely happy. Now we simply need to rotate this 180 degrees. I am going to tell you, don't use flip. That can wreck it in other situations. When you rotate it, notice each click is 22 and a half degrees. If you hold down shift, it's 45 degrees. So doing the 180 is super slick. I'm going to export these as separate files. First, I'm going to grab the green one, choose export, selected shape, STL. Instead of face down, I'm going to put a G in front of this because this is the green one, and hit save. Now I'm going to click on the pink one, export it. Once again, selected shape, STL, and I'm going to give it a P for pink, and save. And then, of course, we need to click on the yellow and export it as well. Selected shape. I'm going to give it that Y and press enter so I can keep track. Now I do know we could select them all and do them as an OBJ. I don't enjoy that though because eventually I have to unzip them, so I find this to be a little bit slicker. While I'm here, I'm also going to grab these two parts. Notice there were two shapes that made that. And we'll export them as well. Selected shapes, STL, and I'm going to name it base face down. Save those changes, and it's time to bounce to Bambu Studio. We're going to hit create a brand new project. I'm using the P1S. We're going to use 0.2 standard, and we're going to bring this in as two separate chunks. First, I'm going to grab these three. I'm going to do shift select to get all of them and do open. I am going to load it as a single object, multiple parts. I'll move it over here for just a second. I'm also going to add the other one, which is the base. Of course, I'll make sure they're in separate areas. And then we're going to move to the object mode to color them. The easiest one, of course, is the base. I'm going to click on it and just switch to yellow. And then we can just use the colors of the objects. Because we put that letter there, we can easily tell that one's the yellow, this one is the pink, and this one is the green. Bang. If we look underneath, you can see it's going to turn out absolutely fantastic. Right now, let's hit slice plate. Check it out, the entire print is going to be done in 50 minutes, and let's hit print plate. Double check our colors, I am happy with that, and let's send it to the 3D printer. And less than an hour later, how cool is that? Alright, so of course this is the original one, where it was printed with them raised up, using switches from Cali. Simply track down the edges and match them to the clicker base. Snap it in, and of course grab the top and snap it in as well. Once you're done, a clicky fidget. How cool is that? All right, so let's run through what we learned. Once again, Sketch Tool is awesome. And if you're going to do separate colors, I recommend that you cut out holes for where each different separate color is going to be and then put the part in there. It works super simple. And then, of course, I also love using the STLs. If you prefer the OBJ files, that's fine by me. It's just not a system I enjoy. Super quickly, I want to say thank you to everybody that supports me via YouTube memberships. Of course, there are three different levels of support, starting as low as $5 a month. With any level of support, you get early access to videos. I also want to say thank you to everybody that is part of my Patreon. Love how that group is growing. We have surpassed 250 users. It is a fantastic messaging area where you can ask questions and learn skills. And of course, you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget, every time you hit that like button, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe. You're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day and keep tinkering.